Hi, my geniuses. I'm Dr. Caroline Pratish. Welcome to my channel, Learn with Carol. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about the circadian rhythm fasting and how it helps me to maintain my weight within the normal range. It's not a big complex word. It just emphasizes when you need to eat rather than what you need to eat. If you have been following, I've been posting videos on my weight loss journey and what I did exactly to lose it all. So you can find the link in the description, so please check them out. Now, the issue of obesity has become a very important concern, especially during the COVID-19 and this lockdown, because all of us are not moving around much, and so is the increase in complications of obesity. And this is true for many other diseases as well. It can in turn affect your blood pressure, your cholesterol, your BMI, and many other. Let's make it easier. Forget calculating your BMI. Just take an inch tape and measure your waist. If you're a man and it is about 90 centimeters, and if you're a woman and the waist circumference measures more than 80 centimeters, then it calls for action. Intermittent fasting, which puts more of an emphasis on when you're eating rather than what you're eating, has actually become a very popular eating style. Not only can you incorporate intermittent fasting into any diet plan, but intermittent fasting has science-backed benefits that range from weight loss to increased energy to reduced risk of chronic health problems like type 2 diabetes. But what if there was an eating plan that took a step further, but not only timing your meals, but making sure those meals are in line with your body's internal clock? Turns out there is. And this less talked about form of fasting is called circadian rhythm fasting, or the circadian rhythm diet, that has some serious benefits. Before diving into circadian rhythm fasting, let's talk about circadian rhythm and why it matters. Your circadian rhythm, also sometimes referred to the sleep-wake cycle, is a 24-hour internal clock that regulates the sleepfulness and wakefulness, or how awake or tired you feel during the course of day. Your circadian rhythm is controlled by an area in your brain called the hypothalamus, which is super sensitive to light. So when your hypothalamus is exposed to light, it sends out signals to the rest of your body telling that it's time to wake up. On the other hand, when it gets dark, your hypothalamus signals to your body that it's time to wind down. In addition to light, there are other major factors that circulate circadian rhythm, and that is your eating schedule. All of this comes down to hormones, two especially: cortisol and melatonin. In a perfect world, cortisol rises in the morning, peaks again in the afternoon, right before your lunchtime, and then drops at night. Melatonin does the opposite. It's the lowest in the morning and then gradually increases as the day goes on. Now, this means, in theory, you wake up in the morning feeling energized and ready to go, then at night you start to feel sleepy and then head off to bed. Now, let's see what is circadian rhythm fasting. The circadian rhythm diet, also called the sun cycle diet, encourages timing your meals with the rise and fall of the sun and corresponding surges and dips in cortisol. That's because cortisol has a significant effect on your thyroid hormones, which affect the metabolism of the food you eat. When cortisol rises in the early hours, your metabolism is also up and running and you effectively use the food you eat as energy. When cortisol dips later in the day, your metabolism simultaneously slows down, which makes it more likely that your body will store the food you eat as fat. Keep in mind that this is how it works with normal cortisol level and cycles. If your cortisol level is too high, like in times of chronic stress, it actually has a paradoxical effect where cortisol contributes to increased body fat, especially in the belly area. So if you're under a great deal of stress, it's important to get that stress under control before doing anything else. Circadian rhythm fasting also considers the role of insulin. So when you eat, especially when you eat a meal that has a lot of carbohydrates, your body releases insulin in response to the rise in blood sugar. If insulin rises at odd times, like when you eat a meal late at night, it can actually disrupt your circadian rhythm and increase your risk for long-term health problems like type 2 diabetes and heart disease. Insulin also promotes the storage of body fat, especially if you eat too much carbohydrates or excess calories. Amy Shaw, who's an MD and double board certified physician expert in intermittent fasting for women, he explained to the MBG like this: all of our cells and organs have clocks that determine when our genes should be turned on and turned off. You can't do all actions in the body at once. So when the sun goes down, usually the action of digestion is turned off and the action of repair and restoration is turned on. So if you eat late at night, you might get slower digestion, inappropriate acid production, and more insulin resistance. This will lead to fat gain, GI symptoms, and diabetes. On the other hand, sticking to an eating schedule that aligns with your natural hormone cycles and avoid late-night insulin spikes can help reduce the risk of developing chronic diseases, type 2 diabetes, heart diseases. Circadian rhythm diet also has other health benefits like weight loss, more efficient metabolism, increased energy, better digestion, reduced inflammation, improved immune function. Timing your meals with your natural circadian rhythm has also been shown to help improve inflammatory diseases like rheumatoid arthritis, inflammatory bowel disease or infections, metabolic disorders, and central nervous system disorders like multiple sclerosis and Parkinson's disease. It has been touted as a powerful way to combat internal and external signs of aging. While it shares similar characteristics with intermittent fasting, the circadian rhythm fasting is a little stricter when it comes to timing. Unlike intermittent fasting, which allows you to determine your feeding schedule as long as you stick to your 12 to 16 hour fasting window, the circadian rhythm diet requires you to stop eating by 7 p.m. Another big difference is that circadian rhythm diet encourages eating breakfast in the morning when the cortisol is the highest. Many people following intermittent fasting actually scheduled their breakfast off, or they skip their breakfast entirely and eat their first meal around lunchtime. The last real notable difference is that the circadian rhythm diet is typically built around the 2-12 hour window. While you extend your fasting window and stop earlier in the day if you want, it is encouraged that you eat between 7 a.m. and 7 p.m. and fast between 7 p.m. and 7 a.m. For comparison, the most popular form of intermittent fasting, which is called the 16-8 or the lean gains protocol, recommends fasting 16 hours a day. While the overall timing of your meals is very important, it's not the only thing to consider when following the circadian rhythm diet. An expert recommends that in addition to eating no later than 7 p.m., you also eat breakfast within 2 hours of waking up and eat no more than 3 meals a day, preferably just 2, like I do. Yes, that means no snacking too. You should focus on building your plate with lean proteins and healthy fat, and avoid processed food and excess carbohydrate. Because the circadian rhythm diet relies on the predictable rise and fall of cortisol and other hormones, it's important that your circadian rhythm is actually functioning as it should. Artificial lights, extended screen time, unpredictable sleep schedules can affect it negatively. It can affect your natural circadian rhythm and throw your hormones out of whack. Eating with your natural sleep-wake cycle can help you start balance your hormones. But if you're scrolling through your Instagram on your phone until 2 a.m., it can negate your dietary effort. So to reap full benefits, it is recommended getting your sleep schedule in harmony with your eating schedule by going to bed between 9 p.m. and 11 p.m. and waking up between 5:30 a.m. and 8 a.m. each morning. Also, getting 2 to 5 minutes of sunlight first thing in the morning can reset the hypothalamus and help with better hormone regulation. My pattern of eating window changed since the lockdown. I eat my first meal between 10 to 11 a.m. and my second meal and the last meal around 3 to 4 p.m. 2 meals per day. I eat anything and everything, of course, a well-balanced meal. This pattern, in combination with the activities I do to burn calories, has really, really helped me to stay healthy. When I say the word healthy, it means full of energy. In my upcoming videos, we're going to be seeing more health related topics. So please stay tuned. Please subscribe, like, comment, and share. Until we meet at our next awesome talk, I'm Dr. Caroline Pritesh with you on Learn with Carol.